Okay. In the launch window, let's do this. Okay. Switching over. T-minus 3 minutes 30 seconds until liftoff, CTS 39. Run through the staging. Spark ignition. Main engine start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Booster ignition. Launch clamp separation. Liquid rocket booster separation. External tank separation. Ohm system prime. Drag chute. Two other chute. TSM carrier attached. Good. All right, we're good. Staging is good.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
Guidance systems are good. Mad Pure Gamer, welcome to Mission Control. You are go at throttle up, buddy. Thank you. Guidance systems are good. Stability assist is good. Crew is nominal. Prop is nominal. All right. Gene, what's up, dude? What's in the fairing on top of the external tank? A couple of SAS modules. Four SAS, dude. Just for it helps with additional stability. It doesn't need them. T minus 2 minutes. What do you think about using one rocket to get two shuttles into space? Why would I need to do that, River? I'm actually curious. I think that's a very, very not safe idea. T-minus 1 minute, stand by for the auto sequence. Go. T-minus 30 seconds, we are go for auto sequence start. Shuttle has primary control of all the vehicle's critical functions. T-minus 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, booster ignition. And we have liftoff, CTS 39, liftoff, carrying the SkyTug mining module and CFO4 crew, supporting the Duna Exploration 2 mission. Shuttle's underway, you go for roll program. Program complete, throttling back engines to 60% of rated performance. Shuttle prepares to go through maximum dynamic pressure. 5 kilometers in altitude, shuttle now traveling at 260 meters a second. Preliminary stage of the ascent here. 10 tons of cargo, 6 crew taking aim on Crookin Station here. And primarily before that, Condor 9 stage rescue. Shuttle crossing the 8-kilometer mark now, 280 meters a second. Would it essentially save you a second rocket? Yeah, but why? Why launch 2 shuttles at once? Other than it's cool. Is this not cool enough for you, man? Coming up on the 1 minute mark, shuttle now traveling at 320 meters a second, 12 kilometers in altitude, standing by for cut 2 for throttle up. Voyager Mission Control, you are go at throttle up. Shuttle now transonic, 15 kilometers in altitude, traveling at 380 meters a second, downrange distance 10 kilometers. Fellas, real quick, if you're asking me questions right now, it's not that I'm ignoring you, so don't get that impression at all. This is very hard to fly. Collins, you really have to make sure, especially when you're inserting into a precise flight azimuth here. I have to make sure that we're orbiting correctly, because one wrong move with this thing and we'll be way off course. This is a very, very precise mission, because I have to get to that stage and I have to line it up so I get to the stage just at the right time where I can send the whole shebang up to Young Station. So if I miss your question right now, it's just because I'm watching the telemetry. I don't mean it. Shuttle now, 29 kilometers in altitude, traveling at 900 meters a second, standing by for third cutoff there. Coming up on liquid rocket booster separation here. 50 at 2.3. I gotta get that descending node down. That's fine. That'll be okay. Thrust trail off on the liquid rocket booster. Stand by for SEP. 51 kilometers in altitude, traveling at 1,900 meters a second. Showing good separation flight. 103 converge. Max, what's going on, buddy? How are you? Sorry, I'm just focusing here. We gotta get that ascending note. That's not good. Cross the ascending to descending. Shuttle. Voyager press to ATO. Voyager, stand by for rollover. Voyager, we have you through Teeters. Stand by, press for Miko. PE. We have main engine cutoff confirmed. Voyager, no ohms one required. Stand by, main engine power down. ETSEP, no ohms one required. Welcome to space. Press to ATO means the shuttle is entering its abort to orbit phase of ascent. Awesome. It's one of the abort contingencies for the shuttle. Once it gets past the ATO phase, it moves into the main engine cutoff phase, which means you've made it to orbit, which is what we just did. Yeah! All right! Turn the music back on. Gnarly ascent right there. Not bad. Opening up main tank. Standby for ET separation. Booster officer reports nominal ET separation flight. What's the DV from the moon to Kerbin? 300 to break moon, no. 200 to break moon orbit, no. No, it is 300 to break moon orbit, inter. What's the deal with that one panel on the bottom of the shuttle? Fuel lines. Awesome. That's the fuel umbilical for the external tank, dude. Alright. I love it, man. I love the internet, dude. The one time I get feisty with chat. Oh, you're acting like a child. Yeah, alright. That's cool. I love it. That's funny. Yeah, Uncle X, you're telling me, man. Alright, I'm gonna have to re-enter the shuttle manually here. We only have 35 units of liquid fuel left and the accompanying oxidizer to go with it. Gotta be very careful. Okay. No, Jackery, this is not after hours. Judo, that's a good question. Do you have to strap into your seat when doing RCS maneuvers, or is a man? All right, here we go. I'm gonna fly her in manual. See if I can use the speed brake and the body flap to keep us in line. The ISS uses traditional LOX engines for maneuvers. I believe it's a hypergolic it's a hypergolic engine. Imagine standing up during a rocket launch. I wouldn't. So I'm using the open body flap out the back of the shuttle to actually keep the nose of the shuttle up, where that's what the Ohms pods would normally do. Keep an eye on our re-entry trajectory. Orient the shuttle, slight bank angle of 30 degrees. Once again, I have the shuttle speed brake open. It usually wouldn't have the speed brake open during this part of re-entry, but I'm really, really low on fuel, and I really don't want to use it unless I absolutely have to. So I'm keeping the shuttle banked at 30, well, not 30, it's probably, we're probably at a 10, 15 degree bank angle at 30 degrees angle of attack. The reason I'm doing that bank angle is because look where our trajectory is going. We're going to use what's called the shuttle's cross-range capability to be able to basically turn us through re-entry and land us back over at KSC. If it runs out of fuel, can you still land it? Yeah. I love that. That's so cool. Hang on, Varak. What is this, dude? Station centrifugal gravity simulation, 196 times. What is this, dude? Whoa. I'm not sure what I'm looking at there. If only you'd play with the reentry particle effects mod. Did they not land the shuttle once manually? STS-2, glass. Joe Engel and Richard Truly manually controlled the shuttle through reentry. I mean, it's not as bad as you'd think. It really depends on where you're trying to get. But if you look, check this out. You could see the cross-range capability of this shuttle. This line right here, which has the stage and Young Station on its orbit right there, if you look, that's our reentry, our original reentry trajectory with no changes. Look at what the bank angle is doing. It's changing my trajectory. There's a significant angle between this and this right here. No, Dirt, we're playing Summer Car for After Hours today, bud. All right, 3-5. I could probably close the speed brake. And we could probably fly on control surface alone. I'm really going to start banking this thing. Because KSC is right there. It's right where the tip of my mouse is, and we're going this way. If I don't keep the shuttle banked like this, we will significantly miss our target. Yeah, that is cool, Varric. Is After Hours happening? The shuttle needs to land, and then, yeah. But look, you can definitely see the cross-range capability of the shuttle. Look at how much our trajectory has changed now. As we've gotten into the thicker atmosphere and the wing surfaces start to control the re-entry of the shuttle. Look at that yellow line is where our trajectory was. That's with no changes. So that if we had a capsule, we'd end up over here somewhere. Look at what the shuttle's doing. It's completely changing the cross-range capability completely adjusting our re-entry trajectory, excuse me. Oh, that's a cool fact, Authoritray. We're still coming in hot here. Baikal range is down here. I don't think you guys can see it though. We need to really start slowing down. So I'm gonna do another S turn. Lower ourselves down a little bit. Now the shuttle would do these during the latter stages of re-entry. It's doing this to expose the bottom of the orbiter, similar to what the cross range would do. Similar to like using its cross range capability, it would do these S turns, roll reversal, roll right, to basically expose the bottom of the orbiter to prograde velocity. Alright, Wheat, if you want to do that, that's fine. Alright. I'm going to do one more S turn. Okay, last S turn. We're now going to circle around here. Oh, 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 oh. Do a barrel roll. Got to remember. I'm so used to seeing the shuttle, like, with, you know, flames around it. I got to remember that we're actually, if when the flames go away, we're actually still going quite fast. But we were at 20,000 when we crossed over the Space Center's, when we went over the Space Center, or the relative longitude of the Space Center. Now the shuttle is turning around, and if you notice, we've bled off 10,000 feet in about 10 kilometers distance. Or 10,000 meters in 10 kilometers distance. And I'm circling around the orbiter. Are you using a joystick for control?
Yeah, Judo.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Okay. Surface indicators are active. 20 kilometers out. I'll try for it, Multi. Now, if you notice, the thing's falling like a brick. Our vertical speed is closer to 100 meters a second. That's pretty high. You ever try this with the keyboard? It's pretty awful. Yeah, I could make it happen with the keyboard, dude, if we really had to. Joystick makes this game infinitely better. You don't need a really expensive joystick. This is like a $40 joystick. It's really, really inexpensive. Does the space shuttle have a joystick or a yoke? It has a joystick. Its controls are derived... No, that's not right. I was going to say its controls are derived from the SR-71, but that's not... I don't think that's right. I want to say that maybe the... No, they're not. I forget. No, it's a joystick, though. So, when you're flying a plane... Can we call it a yoke and not a joystick? Well, yeah, if you want to. Okay, I think this might be enough. Here, let's key the music. Let's see if we can get it right. Game. Alright, here we go. Final correction maneuver. Yes, Sean's. When I land the shuttle, yes. Hey, Laszlo. That's my bit tip alert right there.
Sonic booms just heard at the Kennedy Space Center.
Yep, okay, I got a tally-ho on the tape. Looking good, man.
At the end of a 3 million mile journey, the space shuttle is coming home.
It's too early.
The commander has to make a perfect landing now. He has no engines to take him around again.
Boy, I tell you, that's a good one.
Gotta wait again. Ready?
Right. Okay, got him. I'm gonna get him. Good, I've gotta wait.
Alright, here we go.
400. 3 hit out. Here's coming. 100, 255. 50 feet to 240. 30 feet to 235. 20 feet to 225. 10 feet to 220. 8 feet to 250. 5 feet to 210, 2 feet to 200, 1 foot.
Hey, we were a little off. It was close. We were a little bit off.
Here in the middle of a full wildlife refuge, the
shuttle's live. Oh, jeez. Okay, wheels are stopped. Magnificent!